Welcome to Avalara 1099 and W-9. Let's look together at the process of e-filing a 1099 to the IRS, e-delivery of 1099 copies back to your recipients, and making corrections to past 1099 filings. Now remember that you can use this application to collect and manage W-9s, which creates a lot of time savings because all of your payer and vendor information gets auto-populated when you're creating 1099s. But that's a subject for a different demonstration. For now, we're going to just enter the payer and recipient information manually. Let's begin by adding a new payer. Let's give them a name, enter a federal ID number, a physical address, a phone number, and click Save. Now it's time to add a recipient for the 1099 e-delivery. Let's enter a name, a social security number, a mailing address, and let's give them an email address because after all, this is for e-delivery. Finally, the amount of income this person was paid. Now let's click Save and go to our form summary. You'll notice that the new recipient joins the list of other recipients that I took the liberty of adding before this demonstration. Each of these recipients are marked with different icons indicating their readiness for filing. A green checkmark indicates that they are ready for IRS e-filing and recipient e-delivery. A yellow triangle, though, indicates that they are ready for IRS e-filing, but e-delivery is not possible, most likely due to a missing email address. A red X indicates an error with the form, most likely due to missing income data. You should, of course, go back and fix whatever errors Avalara calls to your attention. But for now, let's proceed to e-file the forms that are actually ready. Proceed to the next step. Schedule a date for the e-filing to the IRS, a date for the e-delivery to the vendor, and even choose whether or not you'd like Avalara to postal mail a copy to the vendor. You can add on an address verification service and TIN matching if you want. Personally, I like to know for sure that my vendor's tax ID numbers are accurate, so I'm going to click Yes. Submit, and you're done. That's it. That's all you need to do to file your 1099s. You can download a copy for your records, but let's take a quick look at the status of your filings. You can see that the IRS e-filing, state e-filing, and recipient e-delivery are all scheduled. The reason e-delivery is a different color is because the recipient hasn't downloaded their copy of their 1099 yet. Once they do, this will automatically change color to green. Finally, what if you need to make a correction to a past filing? Here, you see some that have already been sent. The e-filing to the IRS was a success, but perhaps you just found out that the recipient has since changed their legal name or needs their income adjusted. In that case, all you have to do is click and make the edit. Then click Save Changes. Now you can see that the correction is automatically scheduled for a new e-delivery. If you go back to the form summary, it now says corrected. As always, if you have any questions about what you see here, or if you have a unique use case that requires explanation, we'd be happy to talk further.